You have to leave the city of your comfort and go into the wilderness of your intuition. You can't get there by bus, only by hard work and by not quite knowing what you're doing. But what you'll discover will be wonderful. What you'll discover will be yourself. I look at these distinguished black caps and gowns, and I don't just see young men and women ready to move on. I see the same underdeveloped talents with dreams who came to Stivers hoping to star in Fame and High School Musical, thinking so highly of ourselves that Stivers will be honored to have us. Then we were humbled when we received a 2 as our audition grade. I see seventh graders who aspire to become track stars, practicing their sprints in the 4-minute intervals between each bell. Usain Bolt had nothing on us. I see eighth grade babies who fought daily over French fries in the cafeteria. A true part of our childhood ripped away from us. Thanks, Michelle Obama. Looking closer, I see friends, peers that I now call family, bonds that have flourished in what seems like such a short amount of time. But most importantly, I see growth. Leaders of tomorrow's, innovators, conquerors of their magnets, connoisseurs of the stage, victors of the fields and courts, dreamers that didn't stay asleep, you woke up and started doing. That is why I am proud to call you my classmates. But it did not come easy. We sacrificed, we cried, we were all diagnosed with senioritis of May last year, but we never gave up. Your dedication, perseverance, your dive into the wilderness, your commitment to getting an education, to not becoming another statistic, that is why you are on this stage today. We stepped into the wilderness that was Stivers 6 years ago to discover the you and me presently on this stage. We confronted the ugliest parts of ourselves, celebrated the beauty, and owned the parts that others couldn't understand. We thrive because Stivers has shaped and empowered us to face what's yet to come. It's time. It's time to walk into our destinies. The greatest part about the adventure ahead is that we don't know what it holds. But I know from watching your effort and your strive towards success that in whatever you accomplish on this new journey, you will do it knowing that today, this school made stars. And even after we're gone, we will continue shining, leaving legends, leaving impacts as legends of society. So we say thank you to Ms. Dooley and vice principals for crafting a school that became our second home. Thank you to teachers and staff for providing a great education that compares to no one. A special thank you to Mrs. Daniels for being my mentor and role model in my academics. Thank you for always being disturbed by my singing and staying late nights to make sure I understood Algebra 2, pre-calculus, and AP calculus. Thank you for making math beautiful. To our magnet directors and adjuncts, those who are still here and those who have transitioned on, we say thank you for seeing a 2 in us when we auditioned in seventh grade and transforming us into stars that H auditions for college now. To our families and supporters, thank you for being the loving village to raise us crazy kids, for pouring into us foundations that made us who we are today. We love you. To my class, thank you for coming to Stivers and giving me memories that I will never forget. I am honored to have been your president of this class of 2017. In the words of Bradley Whitford, stars, you must take action. Every story you've ever connected with, every leader you've ever admired, every puny little thing you've ever accomplished is a result of taking action. Graduates, you have a choice. You can either be the passive victim of circumstance, or you can be the active hero in your own life. You are the backbone of this community and the future of this world. Take action in uncomfortable situations because that's where you discover your greatness. Take on challenges that will define you as the person you want to be. Be the stars that shine light to others, because you are the best. The best class of 2017. Congratulations, graduates. Welcome all to the last day of this class, Stivers 2017. Welcome, graduates, to success and to a new wilderness that you are more than prepared to conquer. Thank you.
Been told what to do. Rarely was our decision ever really our decision, and rarely really were our dreams something that we could accomplish on our own. But now the time has come. We are seniors. We've waited many years for this opportunity. We've had to struggle through many sleepless nights, days of heartbreak, sickness, and weeks of hard work, but it has all paid off. From the moment we started school, we knew an education was the key to success. We've witnessed the ups and downs of life and have prepared to take on anything else that stands as a challenge. After learning all of this, there is only one thing left to do, which is to do this on our own. To some, that seems terrifying, but to others, it seems exciting. Independence, freedom, the right to choose our own destiny. It is time to live by these words. But before we depart and go our separate ways, let us reflect on what we have all accomplished together. From the moment you stepped foot into Stivers, your goal was to audition and get into the program your heart desired. Whether it was writing, dancing, acting, drawing, singing, or playing an instrument, you wanted to excel. You wanted to let your talent grow and become a part of who you were. If you are sitting here tonight, then you have succeeded. You have managed to find an art that has taken a part in shaping who you are. But that is not all you get from an education at Stivers. You have also found friends. It may have been difficult at first discovering who the real ones were, but once you knew, you formed a bond with them that no one else could break, an understanding that left you feeling a lot less lonelier than the years before. Now, reflect on all the fun events you attended while at Stivers. Homecoming, prom, the middle school Halloween dance, soccer, volleyball, and basketball games, pep rallies, field trips, Stivers Celebrates, soup dressed up, theater, creative writing, dance, choir, or band performances. All of these were moments we shared together. All of these are memories that form the images that make a scrapbook in our mind. Without them, we would not know about all the things we like or dislike. Without them, we wouldn't be able to witness what a true Stivers Tiger really is. Another thing we should reflect on are the things we appreciate most about Stivers. For example, its diversity. Feminists, homosexuals, transgenders, blacks, whites, Hispanics. This school unites us. Because of our differences, acts of discrimination towards certain groups of people will not go unnoticed by the students or staff. We embrace our uniqueness and do not let closed-minded people keep us from loving one another. This is why we are able to have circle discussions where we share our worries and secrets in theater class. This is why we can talk to our teachers about issues in our lives and know that there are people out there who actually care about us. And in some cases, are going through the exact same thing as us. It lets us know that in reality, we are not alone. So now that we're done reflecting, we should recognize what it means to be doing things on our own. Well, for one, doing things on our own means we're mature enough to handle whatever that task may be, whether it's going to college, finding work, starting a family, or renting an apartment. We are considered adults now, so we must act like them. That means managing your time, finding an appropriate time to go to bed, eating properly, finishing your work, and taking care of your health. This we are still working on mastering. Yeah, you may have excelled at biology, calculus, government, or language arts during your time in high school, but those lessons of self-care are the main ones we must try hard not to forget. Stivers has taught us a lot. It has taught us love, friendship, acceptance, and why it is important to fight for what we believe in. We are surrounded by people who want the best for us. Mr. Asadorian, Ms. Daniels, Mr. Reisner, Ms. Dooley, Ms. Clark, Ms. DeShona, Ms. Whips, Mr. Norsworthy, Ms. Murdoch, Ms. Lane. The list is endless. So we thank you now. Thank you for helping us grow and teaching us to follow our heart. Thank you for challenging us, encouraging us, and supporting us in times of need. Now that we are on our own, we realize that it would be wrong to forget the people who helped us get there. So as we say our final goodbye, we look back to our past and recognize our moments of accomplishments, and we look forward to a future holding many opportunities. Let us be thankful for the blood, sweat, and tears that got us here, and let us be grateful that we finally made it. The time has come, class of 2017. The high school deed is done. Thank you.
The CEO of Apple, Tim Cook, once said, "For the most important decisions in your life, trust your intuition, and then work with everything you have to prove it right." This has been the hardest year for some of us. Not because of the schoolwork, projects, or homework, but because it was time for us to make some life-changing decisions. We had a lot of critical moments this year, as Mr. Unger likes to call them. A critical moment is when a time comes in your life where you must make a decision that will change the rest of your life. Just this year, all of us have had to make extremely important decisions. So, for the most important decisions in your life, trust your intuition and then work with everything you have to prove it right. Trust your intuition. Well, what does that mean exactly? Webster defines intuition as the ability to understand something immediately without the need for conscious reasoning. It's going with your gut feeling, essentially. Now, some of you might not like the part about having no conscious reasoning, which to a point, I would agree with you. However, once you're conscious of something, you begin to think about all of the outcomes that are going to happen if you make this decision, good and bad. Then your mind will naturally begin to think about all the bad things that could happen if you made that decision, which is called worry. However, I encourage you to not worry about such things. Worry is a horrible thing that will break down any great idea into a horrible idea. Civil rights lawyer William Kunstler once said, "All the talk in the world means nothing. It's the doing that means everything." Everything that is popular to us today was just an idea at first. McDonald's, Apple, Stivers School for the Arts. The reason they didn't just stay as some idea is because somebody went out and worked as hard as they could to make it known. And they did not stop after their first failure. Do not stop after your first failure. Failure happens everywhere to everyone. Do not let your fear of failure overcome your passion for success. So once we trust our intuition, we work with everything we have to prove it right. That basically says that once you've made your decision, you need to be able to back it up with why you've made it. You've made your claim, now back it up with evidence, right, Unger? You will always have people that disagree with you, so don't be afraid of that. Disagreement is not a bad thing. I mean, if everyone agreed with everyone else on everything ever, there'd be no source of individuality to anyone. I know for a fact all 140 of us have a lot of individuality that we cannot afford to lose. Do not lose your individuality, and do not forget where you come from. So, class of 2017, if you take nothing else away from what I've said today, take away this. Perfection is impossible. But if you chase perfection, you can achieve excellence. You will never make a perfect decision that pleases everyone. However, if you make a decision, and you trust your intuition, and then you work with everything you have to prove it right, and you chase perfection, you'll have made an excellent decision that many people will support you on. So class of 2017, it is now time for us to make our own decisions, be they planned or just they made up. This world is now ours for the taking. Let's take it. Thank you.
There will be many other nights like this. Thank you.
Yes.
Good evening. Thank you. I would like to open with one of my favorite quotes from Rob Zoltanian. He says, "Here's to the crazy ones, the misfits, the rebels, the ones who see things differently." You can quote them, disagree with them, glorify or vilify them. About the only thing you can't do is ignore them. Because the people who are crazy enough to think that they can change the world are the ones who do. Misfits, rebels, rule breakers. I would consider myself to be a rule breaker. I know for a fact that I'm guilty of breaking several of the rules here at Stivers School for the Arts on multiple occasions. Thank God I made it to graduation. I was actually having a conversation with my mother the other day, and I just so happened to be complaining about school rules, as one who is in school so often does. I was specifically complaining about the rule stating that we're not allowed to play explicit versions of songs at school functions. And I was making the point that it's not my fault that the music of my generation is so vulgar. And of course, she laughed and made the point that rules are in place for a reason and yada, yada, yada. I, of course, zoned out and just said, "Thanks, Mom," but that's not really what I wanted to hear. Anyway, she caught my attention when she said that there were rules that she, too, rebelled against when she was in school. She told me she rebelled by wearing shorts. And of course, that was absolutely wild to me. I mean, what's wrong with wearing shorts? Anyway, she went on to say that 20, 30 years from now, I'll be looking at my kids, and I will be telling them to be grateful for whatever privileges that they'll have that I did it. And as much as I wanted to disagree with her, I knew that she was right. In fact, I've already begun to do it. I look at the seventh graders now and I think, there's no way I was that rowdy, that annoying, or that out of control. But one look at my journal from seventh grade tells me otherwise. And then I realized that it's a generational thing. That every generation is going to look at the next and make comparisons and gripe about how back in my day, we would have never dot, dot, dot. So often, we judge those who come after us because of the change they bring. We feel that what we're doing works, so you know, don't fix what ain't broken. But sometimes we don't see what's broken, because for us, it's always seemed to work. Change is one of the most paradoxical things in this world. It's something that we all desperately need, but do our best to avoid. And we here on this stage are about to embark on one of the biggest changes of our lives. For the past 6 years, most of us have seen the same 150 faces, walked the same halls, and lived very similar lives. Each one of us has strolled through the hallowed halls of Stivers School for the Arts, deep in conversation, laughing out loud, blaring our music through our legal earbuds, oblivious to where we were going because our feet knew the way. But now it's time for our feet to find new ground, to find new footing, to carve new paths, to walk us into change. So, to put a little twist on Mr. Sultana's quote from earlier, here's to the crazy ones, the misfits, the rebels. Here's to us, the class of 2017. To those of us who nay-nay, who whip and dab, who hit them folks and twerk. Here's to our music that overflows with curse words. To our pop stars who are over-sexualized. To us, the artists, the dancers, the actors, the singers, the musicians, and the authors. Here's to our teachers who dealt with our crap, who yelled at us and gave us assignments that we never asked for, but were kind enough to accept when they were late. Here's to us who lead when we know the way and who follow when we don't, who are silent when it is a must and loud even when there is quiet. Here's to us who tweet and Instagram and Snapchat, and we who feel the need to share every part of our lives, because only then can we truly begin to understand and accept each other for who we really are. Here's to us who say yes, we can, and who say no to bigotry, racism, and prejudice. To us who fight for freedom and abolish injustice and stand in the face of evil. Here's to change, and those of us brave enough to embrace it. Thank you.
Astra inclinant, sed non obligant, meaning the stars incline us, but they do not bind us, reminding us that the power of free will is stronger than our astrological destiny. Mark Zuckerberg once shared that taking Latin was the best decision he had ever made. So when it was time to make my seventh grade class schedule, my mom thought it couldn't hurt to follow the footsteps of a billionaire. I was inspired by my seventh grade Latin teacher, Miss Flynn, who told the class great myths of heroes who seem to change the world against the odds. I always thought to myself how amazing Julius Caesar was a strong leader, or Virgil, an eloquent poet, Spartacus, a fearless fighter, Hercules, a great hero. I loved every story and how they connected to tell the history of the world. Some days it felt like I couldn't get to her class fast enough. I think their stories were so intriguing to me because their legacies are still relevant centuries later. And reflecting on what I had learned from their lives, I ask myself, will we be remembered? Will we leave our own legacy? The stars incline us, but they do not bind us. You can check your horoscope every day. You can mark by the position of the moon. You can use your birthday to map out a star or map out a destiny that the universe would have in store for you. Or you can let time pass, as it inevitably will, and use your free will to change the times. College will be a challenge. You may not get the first job you interview for. You may not get a callback for your first audition. Maybe not the second either. Your neighbor will watch you work and say, oh, he doesn't have it in him. And your peers will critique your performance and say, she won't make the cut. But our teachers and adjuncts also gave us critiques and then showed us how to improve. You will hear what people say. The choice you make is whether or not you will listen. I challenge you to create your own destiny. Never allow fear to intimidate you. And when it does, ask yourself, what risks are necessary for you to take for your star to shine a little brighter? And more importantly, are you brave enough to take them? I challenge you to look at those who doubted you and remember how they enunciated the words telling you that you can't. I challenge you to focus on how it feels to be at a disadvantage because the stars were not aligned for you to get your dream job today. I hope you will be brave enough to show the world that it was wrong. Today, class of 2017, I challenge you to follow the stars. I hope you lead like Julius Caesar and fight for freedom like Spartacus, fear nothing like Hercules, use your art to express or write what is in your heart like Virgil, and let your name be proudly remembered for strong will and determination. I dare you to hone your skills and acknowledge your weaknesses. I hope each of you, like Zuckerberg, may take great pride in the best decision that you have ever made. We have been building our foundations for 18 years. Always remember and appreciate your loved ones who have supported you on your journey and help you shine. I would like to take a moment to recognize my mom, who has always believed in me and runs alongside me for every dream I chase. I love you. We are 18-year-old stars. A star burning 18 light years away from where we stand on Earth can die today. But its only legacy, the visible light it emits, can still be seen shining in the night sky for another 1,800 years. And a light year may be too far to travel in our lifetimes, but if you remember to challenge yourself, one day you will reflect and see that you've traveled farther than you ever could have imagined you would have yesterday. The stars incline us, but they do not bind us. I dare you to create your own destiny and this world that awaits you, so that our stars, long after we have gone, will still be visible shining light years away. Congratulations, class of 2017. Your teachers, adjuncts, mentors, family, and friends will all be looking up to the evening sky tonight, admiring how beautifully we shine. Thank you and farewell.
Good evening. To Superintendent Rhonda Kaur and to members of the Dayton Board of Education, it is with great pleasure that I do hereby certify that each of these candidates in the class of 2017 has met or exceeded all Carnegie Unit and Ohio graduation test requirements set forth by the Dayton Public Schools and the Ohio Department of Education. Superintendent Kaur, I present for your acceptance the Stivers School for the Arts class of 2017.
Good evening. Greetings, Board Member Lacey, members of my cabinet, staff, teachers, parents, families, and especially our graduates from Stivers. I am honored to stand before you today as your superintendent and want to wish the very best to the class of 2017. Today is commencement day. It brings to a close one chapter of your life, but commencement is truly about a beginning, a new beginning, a new chapter. No matter where you're from, your dreams are valid, so dream big. As Walt Disney said, all our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them. So pursue them fiercely and with great passion. You will all embark on new journeys today. Many of you will be attending colleges. I want to congratulate this very special Stivers class that has earned nearly $13.5 million in scholarship money. Very impressive. Some of you will go on to join our armed services. Many will start employment. Just never lose sight of your dreams, and don't ever let anyone tell you what you cannot do. You may have to leave your comfort zone to grow, but with hard work and some risk, you'll discover who you really are and all that you can be. Keep the faith and always believe in yourselves. We do. You are all loved a great deal by your families that are here today, by your community and beyond. Always remember, we all need people in our lives that care for us as individuals and who want the best for us. Stay close to those people. Know your circle and be good to those that always have your back. These people, many of whom who are with you today, and thank you to all the parents and grandparents and aunties and uncles and cousins and brothers and sisters that have supported these amazing graduates. You are both priceless and irreplaceable. Please stay by their side as they go through this journey. And at some point, you will have to make difficult decisions through this journey called life. Be both reflective and mindful of your elders, your mentors, and the people that support you. Robert Frost's poem, The Road Not Taken, is the perfect example. There will come a time when roads diverge, and you will have to choose your path. Take the one less traveled, and it will make all the difference in the world. Dare to be different and exceptional. Dare to become greater. Be determined to succeed and to continue down the path, regardless of any barriers that you may face. be the change. Once again, on behalf of the Dayton Board of Education and our entire staff, congratulations on your graduation from Stivers High School today. Best wishes in all of your future endeavors, and we are your supporters, and we'll be cheering you on every single step of the way. And with that being said, Principal Dooley, as the Superintendent of Schools, and by the powers entrusted to me by the Ohio Department of Education and the Dayton Board of Education, I do hereby accept these candidates for graduation and release their diplomas to be presented in this ceremony. Board Member Lacey, it is my honor to commend to you the Stivers Class of 2017.
Thank you, Madam Superintendent. Dayton Public School administrators, Principal Dooley, faculty and staff of Stivers School of the Arts, parents, relatives, and friends, and graduate candidates. I haven't gotten a chance to speak before you for 10 years. I believe it was 10 years ago in the class of 2007 was the last time I got to speak. And it is truly an honor to be able to speak with you. We board members, we take turns. But I think since it's been 10 years and there are 7 board members, somebody jumped ahead of me. But I don't blame them, because this is truly one of the best, and I appreciate the chance to come and see you. Since 10 years, I've had a child, and I'm honored to be here to congratulate her babysitter. I also want to congratulate you on your $14 million in scholarships. I believe it's more than $14 million, so congratulations. They've earned some more since the principal was talking. It'll be more later. I want to offer you the life lesson, because we're always supposed to do that. I remember Percy Mack used to, his life lesson was not to accept credit card offers. Mine, you've heard pretty much the same. I might put it in different words. You will face many contests in the years ahead. If anyone insists that you have to lose, don't listen to them. If anyone tells you that the other guy has to win, no matter what authority they claim to have, for they have lost all rights to that authority, you should ignore them. And that's my simple life lesson. And now I shall bestow upon you. And in the past 10 years, I've begun the bestowal phrase. It's grown to 4 languages. So you're going to have to listen to it in 4 languages. The first one will be English, or my version of English. On behalf of the Dayton Board of Education, I accept these students commended to me by the superintendent. And they shall be here forward deemed graduates of the Dayton Public School System. And they shall be here forward bestowed with all rights, privileges, and responsibilities afforded to graduates of the Dayton Public School System. En español, por Dayton Board Education, yo acepto estos estudiantes recomendado por su supervisor. Ellos serán graduados de Dayton Escuela Público y tendrán todos los derechos, privilegios y las responsabilidades como graduados de Dayton Escuela Público. That's one of my better ones. En français, de la part du conseil d'éducation de Dayton, j'accepte ces étudiants recommandent de la part du directeur. Ils seront diplômés estimés ici des enfants du système d'école publique de Dayton. Ils seront ici affrontés à corps des avec tous les droits, les privilèges et les responsabilités qui leur permettront d'être diplômés du système d'école publique de Dayton. And this is the struggle, Turkish. Dayton. I don't even try with this one. Dayton. Egitim Kurulu Edina. Mufetis Terafindan Bana Emenet Edilin Bu Ogren Silere Kubil Kabul Ediorum. Ogren Silere. Bu andan itibaran Dayton devlet okulu sistemi imezen lari sailasaklar ve Dayton devlet okulu sistem mezen larina taninan tum haik imtiaz ve surum luluklar anlara de taninas. Some of these have about 12 syllables. Tanina. But it's a beautiful language, and either way, I totally respect it. Tanenakakdir. Congratulations. Felicitaciones. Tut no felicitum. Tebrik ediris.
Zaid Josiah Walters. Tony Jarrell Boddy Jr. Cameron Jerron Clay. Alvin Christian Dennis. Quinn Patrick O'Hara. Macy Elizabeth Hudson. John Warren Lewis. Charles Richard Bruff IV. Jalen Dwayne Moore. Miles Evan Clark. Ruslan Anvarovich Taksalov. Kali Dajur Relaford. Robert James Benson. Alexis Ray Diggs. Paris Dion Menifield Jr. Shira Janice Benson. Mikeyon Wilson. Sophia Rose Dorty Minos. Gabriel Renee Gonzalez. William Gabriel Bell. Carlos Ivan Ambrosio. Dejun Lee Simmons. Kiara Lene Gibson. Aziz Faradinov Shadmanov. Blake Hunter Campbell. Simon Niall Kingston. Austin Stephen Cook. Malcolm Wesley Edwards. Brooklyn Aaliyah Seard. Nadja Ray Dewberry. Marcus Omi Jr. Cameron Ryan Blake. Makara Hope Blake. Tiffany Diamond Pauly. Caitlin Lee Schielich. Sarah Catherine Martin. Skylar Brianna Coker. Michaela Renee Thompson. Madison Arisha Cameron Brown. Rakia Chantel White. Kyra Lynn Elizabeth Bibb. Noah Sinclair Beckham. Dominique Lachey Vinay. Maya Opal White. Kaylee Morris. Tamara Lynn Laritz. Jacqueline Eleanor Roser Adkins. Anthony Demetrius Lee. Jara Elise Lauderdale. Ashley Morgan Cheek. Mallory Ann Pavey. Haley Tatum Denner. Destiny Arzell Bass. Talia Royale Simone Thomas. Cheyenne Nicole Hopkins. Rebecca Renee Ross. Olivia Rose Ihenia Alanis. Timothy Paul Fry III. Jubilee Renee O'Connor. Isabella Christine Cambreros. Kylie Elizabeth Fine. Colin Michael Coomer. India Nicole Foster. Gabriella Christine Neuer. Destiny Ariel Jalice Donaldson. Shanna Marie Harvey. Maya Amari Smith Custer. Craig Allen Jordan Jackson. Del Edward Jackson III. Valencia Antoinette Pauly. Caitlin Ann Ganote. James Fields IV. Amber Rochelle Butler. Robert Gordon Williams. Alexander Joseph Packlib. Nathan Scott Quinn. Dantoria Bratina Watson. Janaya Lachey Thompson. Casey Brianne Heflin. Rajane Elise Green. Kyla Atalai Jesse. Ariana Jasmine Matthew. Brandy Brianne Melanie D. Smith. Tia Andrea Ruffin. Angelina Serna Cruz. Lauren Shea Baker. Devon Janae Liana Howard. Nautica Jalen Nichelle Finley. Eris Chanel Doherty. Kenna Renee Seabrook. Mercy Love Spencer. Julie Perez. Aaliyah Nyche Nellums. Brittany Danielle Coleman. Alexis Shailene Marie White. Taylor Rain Lassen. Dana Shanice Bolden. Darian O. Jones. Kristen Lachelle Rains. Asia Nicole Mahadi. Aisha Shamar Wood. Ellie Antonina Reith Barber. Allie Viola Joy Hawkins. Laura Christina Ankeny. Kenzie Moore. Mercedes Sophia Perez. Sophie Lauren Booker. Janaya Nyche Roseway. Anna Shea Jewett. Alexis Lynn Williams. Avion Elizabeth Noel Hudson. Christopher Patrick Bollinger. Elizabeth Rose Romer. Casey Miranda Clark. Isaac W. Robinson. Hannah Elizabeth Walters. Elijah Hill. Marcel Travion Edwards. Philip Gary Buxton III. Imrambe Sardalovich Kabibov. Joshua William Cecil Carson. Johnny Lee Henry III. Jade Tierra Cusar. Jada Ciara Cooper Taylor. Denisha Kishana Dixon. Dylan Matthew Turner. Ta Imhotep Emisa Adu. Carly Josephine Vagadas. Cameron O'Shea Scott. Austin Jamal Lee. Dejaya Antoinette Bristow. Tyler Scott McKenney. Adrian Clyde Jones Jr. Robert Lee Harrison III. Taylor Nicole Abreu. Xavier Alexander Swartz. Tyrese Tyrell Bailey. Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, cherished alumni, it is my honor and privilege this evening to present to you the Stivers School for the Arts graduating class of 2017.